AFL is set for a showdown in the Supreme Court as 30 former players launch a landmark class action over the impact of concussion. For more, let's bring in Eddie McGuire. He's got a big announcement today too in Melbourne. Eddie, good morning to you. Everything's right with the world when you're back on the Today Show. The AFL, they must have seen this coming, right?
Oh, yeah, there's no doubt about that, Karl. And look, World Sport has seen it coming, haven't we? We've seen all the investigations into whether the heading of the ball in soccer, American gridiron, any contact sport, boxing over the years. So, yeah, I don't think there's any surprise in this. And, look, I hope it gives the AFL and everybody around the place an opportunity to look at it. What do we want in our game? Do we want to have the physical clashes? Is that part of it? Do you sign up for that from the moment you pull boots on and go forward? But also, how do we look after players who may have been able to, whose lives have been changed irreparably because of these head injuries. So there's so much to this. And, it's a bit like, Alzheimer's and any head injury. There are theories promulgated that then are dispelled. Everybody wants to get to the bottom of this. So, sometimes these things can be a good thing.
I wonder how the game does move forward, given the complexities.
Well, every game. I mean, that's the situation, Karl. I mean, we talk about helmets. Do you change the rules? There have been rule changes. I mean, I remember as a 13, 14-year-old, my job was to go down to get the injuries reports after what was the VFL in those days. And you get somebody who had concussion. It was an automatic 1 week. They're off for a week. Then doctors came out and said, no, it's actually an electrical situation. Sometimes it could be 3 weeks. Sometimes they could play later on in that game. I mean, you had players who would then be cheating on their concussion tests so they'd be able to go back on. The theory back in the day was any injury above the shoulders didn't count. Yeah. That was what it was. It was a test of your mental strength and that type of thing. Then you have the other situation where are there lifestyle issues with certain athletes that mitigate against their recovery? Drugs, alcohol, all that sort of thing. Training during the week. We know that boxers probably get more head injuries in the sparring sessions than they do in the ring. So it's a good thing to sit down, and we do need to look after people who have been hurt in this situation. I don't think anyone should be scared of this. And we always say this, the AFL are going to be after this and, the class action. Good that there's a class action. Now let's work through it.
Okay. Hawthorn and Richmond fans want some pies seat at the G, right? I mean, I've always known you to be an incredibly generous man. Why don't you just help a brother or sister out, hey?
Yeah, we did, mate. That's why they're still playing, because we helped them out for years.
No,
that's a deal that was... What do you reckon, Sarah? I mean, seriously, come on, mate.
One-eyed pie.
Turn it up. The one thing, I'll tell you what happens, right? The one thing that Collingwood did over the years was look after its members, right? When the MCG was friendless, when they were all running down the road to what is now Marvel Stadium, when Richmond was going to Cairns and Hawthorn were getting $500,000 and $5 million a year down at Tasmania, one team sat in the building site. It's called Collingwood. Right? The deal's done. Hey, Jeff Brown, don't worry about me, mate. I'm just arguing because they're going to move my seat. But it's Jeff Brown who's the president. He'll get in and Craig Kelly. I'm sure it'll be sorted out. And I'm sure that the good folk at the MCC who understand integrity, Carl, won't dud the people who looked after them in the hard days.
Awesome.
I'm sure they will, because the next time I'll have a big photo of them right here on the Today Show. Point out, okay?
All right, I'm not messing with Brownie either, ever. Before we go, you're back on 3AW this year. This is fantastic news. Homecoming for you. Back doing what you love.
Well, it'd be interesting. I mean, I was at Triple M for 30-odd years trying to destroy 3AW, and now I'm going across, but only for a couple of things, Carl. There's a quid there, I'm there. Calling a couple of games, right? I'm actually filling in for long service leave and people like that just on an ad hoc basis. Yeah. I'm not really, back in as part of the 3AW team. But what we are doing is a fantastic Monday morning podcast with Brownlow medalist Jimmy Bartel, the superstar, which will then lead into Wednesday night's Footy Classified. So coming up this year, the rights holders, they don't do any TV shows. Garlitz left the Channel 9 to pull up all the slack
we
in the AFL.
Well.
So Sunday morning footy show. Monday night footy classified and then Wednesday footy classified as well. So all your footy news there. And hey, don't forget to what a night last night though, Carl. Our women's cricket team, sensational. Manchester United gets up, but you've buried the lead. I haven't heard anything about Glasgow Celtic 2-1 over Rangers with Ange Postecoglou. And Aaron Moy set up the 3 goals, 2 for Celtic and 1 for Rangers.
Always good to have you on, Eddie. You make me feel inadequate. as always, thank you, buddy. Good luck with it.
It's good to have Sarah, good Collingwood supporter there these days. Good on you, Sarah. Fly the flag, will you?
Oh, yeah. Don't you worry about that, Eddie.
Thank
I got to come
Eddie.
In.
Best of luck, mate.
Landmark class action lawsuit could change the way the AFL deals with concussions forever, as 30 former AFL and AFLW players prepare to take the game to task over previous head injuries. Let's bring in Nine Adelaide presenter Tommy Wren. Tom, good morning. The NFL in the US, it's been through this and more. Now the AFL here. Will we see the same results, do you reckon?
It feels like it could be the tip of the iceberg, doesn't it, Alex? And we know the AFL and the NRL, for that matter, have moved heaven and earth to really try and stamp out concussion in terms of protecting the head and, you know, trying to alleviate the pressures on head injuries for players. But the problem is these injuries go back many generations, and unfortunately we're seeing the effects of repeated head knocks and the relation to CTE, which is a brain disease, and a lot of former footballers have suffered from this, and, you know, there's that direct correlation. So it does feel eerily similar to what the NFL has been through, and there were huge compensation payouts that have happened over there. So it does feel as though this could be the start of what could be a lot of legal action coming forward for not only the AFL, but I suspect the NRL as well.
Yeah, I was just reading about Crows wingman Paul Seedsman. I mean, he's out for the year, isn't he, with concussion problems he's suffered in the last couple of years. I worry about him, but it's too late for a lot of these players, isn't it?
Well, exactly right. And that was a concussion injury he suffered in the 2022 pre-season. So that was the end of 2021. And he hasn't played since. I mean, he has real issues just even going outside, you know, issues just with the sunlight. So it's a significant problem, not only for past players, but current players as well. Careers being cut short, unfortunately, for players, really good, solid players too, like Paul Seedsman. So this is a significant landmark case that is happening. You know, players that are suffering the worst of these injuries reportedly seeking up to $2 million in compensation. So this is going to be a real test case for the AFL and for sport in Australia, I think. So watch this space really closely.
All right, Tom. And we're thinking of you, Paul. We hope you get well soon. Thanks, mate.
The AFL is this morning facing a landmark class action by former footballers suffering the effects of concussion injuries. Live to Isabella Staszkowski, who's at AFL House for us this morning, is that this action would be the first of its kind in Australia.
Brooke, good morning to you. It certainly would be. Melbourne law firm Margolett Injury Law says it's time to hold the AFL to account. It wants to go all the way to the Supreme Court and claims it has 30 former AFL and AFLW players who are willing and ready to go all the way in this concussion class action. It claims these former players with specific kinds of severe former injuries and continuing injuries could be compensated more than $2 million. The AFL, meanwhile, has released quite a lengthy statement. In part of that, it details the changes made over the past two decades. It also discusses the potential expansion of a program looking at financial assistance for those with these kinds of severe injuries. Either way, Brooke, debate will certainly continue over this incredibly important topic in sport.
It absolutely will. Thanks, Izzah.